well, Iceland is an island in the middle of the Atlantic Ocean, and we are very isolated geographically. And many years ago, I got this idea about writing about what would happen if we would be completely cut off from the rest of the world without explanation. There would be no contact, no telephones, no radio signals. The ships would leave and never come back. The airplanes would leave and we would never hear from them again. And what would happen to our society and the people living in the country if we lost contact with the outside world? I wrote the book before Trump, before Brexit, before Orbán came to power in Hungary and what happened in Poland and etc. So the book knew more about what was going to happen in Europe than I did. I'm very concerned about what's happening to democracy and politics in our part of the world, and I wanted to write about that. But the book has turned out to be more true than I ever believed it would be. I think isolation is very much a part of the national psyche, our part of being. We're always thinking about being at home or going abroad. We actually have our word for being educated is to have sailed. We always define ourselves from the outside. We see ourselves as isolated and we go abroad to get information, to get contact, to get trade, to get everything we need. So just cutting off all that contact for me was a very interesting and it was a very, very wholesome thought experiment. I wanted to write about the connection between the media, the news media, and politics. It's something I deal very much with in my daily job as an editor and a television journalist. And we have a very sensitive, very precarious contact to power, not only in Iceland but everywhere. We are dependent on getting the information. We let politicians use us, but we cannot let them abuse us. And I wanted to see what happened if journalists became too afraid to ask difficult questions, if they became too dependent on power, and if everybody became too afraid to be critical of the situation. When the Icelandic economy crashed in 2008, I was working at the newsroom and we were making news stories about how we could survive, because everybody thought we were going to be like North Korea because we didn't pay our debts and we closed off the country and didn't pay any of the debtors. And we didn't know what was going to happen. Respected economists, they went to the shop and they just bought lots of rice and pasta and stuff because they were afraid that there was not going to be enough food in the country. So we started making news stories about what would happen if all trade was cut off. And at first it was like, okay, it's fine. We have all the fish, we have all this clean energy, we have our farmers making food for us. But when we got further into the news making, we started thinking, okay, if we don't have any oil, how are we going to do this? If we don't have the medicine, if we don't have the fertilizer for our fields, how are we going to produce enough food for our people? So it started off as a news story, but it was a very limited way of tackling the problem. And I was always fascinated by using my imagination and using literature, a more literate form of writing to explore the subject.